welcome back to Duchess of Success. First of all, thank you so much for 6k subscribers. I am just so taken back by how fast this channel has grown and all of your support. It makes my day so much better. I really look forward to just sitting down and doing these podcasts at the end of the day. And I'm working on so many things for this channel, and I believe that 2022 is going to be the best Sussex Squad year yet. I appreciate you all, my friends, and I'll be here for as long as you want me to keep yapping my gum. Over in Montecito, where we're minding our own business and living our best lives, our Sunshine People had their very first Montecito holiday car parade, and guess who was the first to sponsor this inaugural event? Yes, our faves. They were mentioned in an article in the Montecito Journal. Although they weren't seen at the parade, it seems like everyone who went had a good time and appreciated the generosity of all of the donors. Megan was also packed out and about shopping in town, but I know how some squaddies feel about non-official work engagement photos, so I won't post them here, but if you lurk around Sussex Squad, Insta and Twitter, you would have seen them. Megan was just shopping and looking pretty okay, probably getting a few gifts. And one thing I know that we're all waiting for, both Megan fans and Megan haters, who, as I'm sure we've established by now, are more obsessed with her than her fans, we are waiting for that Christmas card. I think that we will see a Christmas card. I have no reason to think otherwise because we've seen a card every year so far from the Sussexes. I just think that they will make sure to protect Lily and Archie. We know how those children are treated and targeted every single time they're seen, even with the photo that Megan released on Ellen with Archie's back to the camera. People started on these hater channels with their ridiculous conspiracy theories. But maybe they will surprise us and we will see their faces, who knows? I think that Megan and Harry want to strike a balance between protecting their children and understanding that their fans do want to see them. But of course, the protection of the children always comes first. So I think they'll find a way of striking that balance. I just hope that as and when they do release the photo, it's at a really annoying time in the early hours of the morning here in Britain so that the press can't print it on their front papers in time. Like if they were to put it out past printing time in the early hours of the 25th, it won't make the covers for Christmas morning. And speaking of newspaper covers, what is taking so long with the apology? I hope the reason the Daily Fail hasn't yet put out the apology isn't because they're seriously going to appeal to the Supreme Court. There was word that they might, and with the British government now throwing their hat into the ring, this could get messy, and the political arena in Britain is messy enough that the British government really don't need to be getting involved with the tabloids in their temper tantrum. But the government is being held by the balls, so they're probably going to do whatever it is Lord Rothermere and his mafia tell them to. I mean, just let it go already. We're also still waiting to hear how much damages they will have to pay to Meghan. There were several articles posted with Meghan's letter, and I believe that Meghan is seeking damages equal to the profits made from those articles. Next, Lewis Hamilton was knighted, and this has divided a lot of opinions, some people saying that it's hypocritical of him as he has been heavily vocal about Black Lives Matter. In one of my recent videos, I pointed out that Gina Martin, who is a white activist, turned her honour down and specifically mentioned that the monarchy's colonial past was the reason that she turned her honour down. And there have been many people, both people of colour and white people also, for a variety of reasons, who have turned down Queen's honours. Here's my thing about this. I think in Lewis's position, he can't win no matter what he does. If he takes the title, he's seen to some as a hypocrite. If he denies the title, he's seen to some as dissing the Queen, and in the eyes of crazed royalists, dissing Britain, and the British press will come at him. Even though you can still proudly be British and not in favour of a monarchy, those two things aren't mutually exclusive. I don't understand why that is so hard for people to grasp. Also, nowadays, because more and more people are turning honours down, they would have likely asked him in private first. So say that they had asked him and he said no, but he didn't publicly come out and talk about it. As far as the public would know, they just didn't offer him one at all. So then the conversation would become, why wasn't Lewis offered a knighthood? Even though he may have been offered a knighthood, he just turned it down in private. So either way, can't win. I honestly can't wait for the day that people just come to their senses and realize that the whole honor system is a waste of everyone's time. And last but not least, to end on something positive, congratulations to Simone Biles for getting Times Athlete of the Year. She had a very difficult Olympic Games and still managed to bag a bronze medal, even though she was performing not at her best. But I can't even imagine the mental demons she had to work through going back to the Olympics, when the last time she was there, her and her fellow athletes were being betrayed and abused by their doctors and ignored by their coaches and US sports leadership. And following the games, she gave her testimony about her abuse at the hands of Larry Nassar. And guess who was pretty much the only tabloid rodent to attack her? Like, he attacks all women he knows he can get some press clout from if he mentions them. That's right, piss moron, attacking a sexual abuse victim, doing her best under pressure in front of the world. That clown is going to get his comeuppance and it's going to be glorious. That's all for now, my lovelies. Can't wait to see you at Saturday's party. I hope you're ready. I am. See you there, my lovelies. Ciao.